Hi and hello, welcome back to another short trick video from the short trick video series from Knowedge. I'm Sia here and I'm going to teach you a short trick on percentages. Percentage problems are asked in almost all competitive exams, and rather than doing it in the old traditional method, you can follow this technique and do it in the smartest way and save time. Okay, but before that, I request all of you to click on that subscribe button and the bell icon too, because I have a lot of interesting and useful short trick videos in my channel which will come handy to you anytime. So let's begin by understanding what is percentage. Per means one and cent means 100. So basically percentage means you're going to find the value for 100 of the given number. So it means if you have scored 100 on 100, then that means you have scored 100% in your exams, right? Great. So that's what it is. Basically 100% means full value. Full value. And 50% means half value. So if you want to find 50% of something, then you can divide the whole number by 2 to get the value. So the next one is 25%. It's obviously half of 50%. So you can divide the 50% value by 2 to get the value of 25%. The next one is 10%. Now you have to jump one digit to your left of the given number and then place a decimal there. Yeah, that's your answer. So basically if you have 350, then move one digit, place a decimal here, and that's your answer. So 35 is 10% of 350. Now comes 5%. Obviously 5% is half of 10%. You can just divide the value of 10% by 2 to get the value. So half of 10%. Lastly is 1%. This time you have to jump two digits to your left and place a decimal. So for the same 350, you will move two digits and place a decimal here. So your answer will be 3.5. So basically these are the landmark percentages. So if you know how to find the value of all these percentages, then you can find the percentage of any given number within no time. Okay, so let's start with the basic example. We have 4500 here, and now as you all know, 100% of 4500 is 4500 itself, and if you want 50% of 4500, then it means you have to divide 4500 by 2. So 2250 will be your answer. And now if you want to find 25% of 4500, then you know the value of 250%. So half of 50% is 25%. So divide 2250 by 2, and 1125 will be your answer. Okay, so now you want to find 10% of 4500. As I said, you have to place a decimal after one digit to your left. So 4500, place a decimal here, so it's going to be 450. Okay, now for 5%, now that you know the value of 10%, you can divide it by 2 to get the value. So your answer is 225. The last one is 1%. Now this time, do you remember how many digits we have to move to place a decimal? Exactly, it's 45, because you are placing a decimal after two digits this time, so it's going to be 45. Great. Let's move on to the next example. We have 8200 and you want to find 12% of it. So how are you going to go about it? This 12% is not there in our list. We have 100, 50, 25, 10, 5 and 1, but we don't have 12. So how to go about it? You know the value of 10% and you know the value of 1%. So why don't we split it as 10% plus 1% into 2? Does this make sense? Exactly. So you have 10% means, as I said, place a decimal after one digit. So it's 820, then plus. Now you know the value of 1%, place a decimal after 2 digits now. So it's 82. 82 into 2 is 164. So now your answer is 984 after adding these two digits. Got it. Now tell me how this can be done. 525 and you have to 565 percentage. Now how will we split it? You know the value of 50 percentage. You know the value of 10 percentage. Now it's already 60. And the remaining 5 percentage. Okay, so 50 percentage of 525 is 262.5 and 10 percentage is, you have to place a decimal here, so it's 52.5 and 5 percentage is a half of 10 percentage, right? So it's going to be 26.25. Now add all this, you are getting 341.25. Easy, isn't it? Don't you think rather than multiplying and dividing, adding makes it simpler? So that's the magic of this trick. So let's see if you can do this. You have to find 98 percentage of 2800. Are you saying that you're going to do 50 percentage then plus 10 percentage into 4 will give you 40? This is 90 now. And then you're going to give 1 percentage into 8. It will be 8 percentage and that will give you 98 percentage. See, you know the value of 100 percentage. You know the value of 2 percentage, meaning 1 percentage into 2. Now, why don't you subtract this to get the value of 98 percentage? So, 2800 and then 1% is, you have to move 2 digits and place a decimal. So, it's going to be 28 into 2, which is 56. So subtract this from 2800 and your answer is 2744. Isn't this great? Aren't you getting excited? Then try this one. You have to find 83 percentage of 14600 and then post your answers in the comment box. I know this is an amazing trick. So quickly share it to your friends and just give me a thumbs up right away. So that's all for now. Until I come up with the next trick, keep waiting and bye-bye.